we want to make potato battery, 3 potatoes, zinc plates, small plates, copper plates, and LED bulb. To measure the voltage, we have multimeter. With this, we are making a potato battery. When we are collecting zinc and copper plate in potato, potato is rich in phosphoric acid, lot of ions are there. So we are getting it reacts, a lot of electrons are getting freed, that moves from zinc electrode to copper electrode, it moves. So it reacts, chemical reaction occurs, we get potential developed across the electrode. Here we connected one potato. It is connected through wire, multimeter is connected. It is generating 0.96 voltage. This potato it has connected 0.96 voltage. Similarly, two other potato we will connect and we will check. Now, two potato batteries are connected. So, it is generating roughly 1.4 voltage. You see, 1.5, 1.6, it is varying. This much it is generating two potato battery. Now, three potatoes are connected. So, it is measuring 2.6 voltage, around roughly 2.6 voltage. So, it is sufficient to light LED, which is rated for 2 to 3 volt. So, we can glow the bulb. So, this three potato generates roughly 2.6 volt. That means what? For every 1 coulomb of positive charge, it generates, it gives about work done, it does work about 2.6, 2.7 joules on every positive coulomb of charge. That is the meaning of that. Okay, now we will check the light is glowing or not. Now you can check, the bulb is glowing, green color bulb is glowing nicely. So it is glowing, okay. It is very beautifully it is glowing. That you can check how it is glowing. By removal you can see it removes. It is switched off. You connect, it glows. Okay. It is nicely, it is glowing. It is nicely glowing. Potato bulb. This way it works, potato bulb. Beautifully it glows. So, it generates. We are able to generate electricity from the electrolyte. It is chemical reaction. That is a beautiful project to understand a lot of things.